This year is special because we have all the juries from product, communication, packaging, as well material together here. And we have a big group of jury members. It's quite interesting and challenging to handle this. And I'm looking forward to have this kind of discussion with my colleagues here today, tomorrow, and the day after tomorrow. And it will be very exciting.
I think it's very good that all the four juries are here at the same time. And you have an overview of all the four categories.
First impression so far is the size, you know, the amazing scale of work from all over the world.
There's such an overwhelming number of different kind of products, from small household things all the way to big heavy industry tractors.
At this point you can have a better connection.
Are you thinking from a density point of view?
The new geometrical.
Maybe you need
thing.
Less space for installing all this.
Or you get more.
That's the benefit.
The challenge is to keep patient the whole time, not to get tired, to take each product in the hand as far as possible, to open the doors, to lock the doors, to switch the switches, and to give each product the same chance as you maybe did in the morning, give the same chance to the products to get positive judged also in the evening. This is, I think, the biggest challenge for the judges here in this IF jury.
We're focusing on the classical IF categories, which is functionality, technology, aesthetics, sustainability. We are focusing on, of course, innovation.
Well, for me, it's very important that things are solving a good problem, you know. If you come up with a problem from cloud cuckoo land, I think you're making up problems which are not there. Then you have to solve that problem, and you have to solve it so it serves the function that it wants to serve. And you should clean it up a bit. You shouldn't make it like a big mess, and you should also pay attention to the details.
I really enjoyed the battle of the vetoes. It's made okay, but really not more than that.
It was a clear and nice to handle product.
The question is, you know, when you're not used to those high-tech stuff in Europe, I mean, in Japan it's a standard, or in Asia, for us it's not a daily object, so it's hard to imagine, is it a evolution or not, if it's a good design.
It might be a cultural thing, and I'm pretty sure it might work pretty good, and I know the Asian people, they really use it. In the Western countries, it's not common so far. It might be common in a few years.
Who would like to have it in?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Who
would like to have it out?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
7. In. Well, I think we're all really happy with the final selections. I think. We all work really well together. We were able to challenge each other in a really good way. But I think what the best designs rose to the top. Yeah. I also think it's really beneficial, especially with product design, to actually have the product in place. We were able to do it with some, but having the physical item in hand is very helpful.
But I think the designs that we finally chose are very are things that have this nice details that make you smile.
We've seen some very, very nice entries, very inspiring entries. Some works were absolutely groundbreaking.
Good impression. I think we had two good days.
A lot of entries, a lot of work, and we saw everything from good to bad.
It was just amazing and to see such a high quality of the old design quality.
Overwhelming.
Overwhelming.
Overwhelming.